I am looking at these teacher guides, and these lessons seem really long and detailed. How do I know which parts are important?
Well, that's a great question. So as we've talked about selecting an evidence-based intervention or evidence-based strategy, it's important to implement that evidence-based intervention or strategy with fidelity. And so that's what Mr. Flores's question is. He's got this teacher guide, and what is important? What does he have to do, and what should he do, and what are some of the things that he might want to leave out? So that brings us here to Module 8. Here we're going to talk about DBI and mathematics and two things that are really important within thinking about putting DBI and mathematics together. First, we're going to talk about fidelity, which is what Mr. Flores' question is. How much of this intervention program do I need to implement in order to implement it well? And then we're going to talk about the adaptations that should be made when our progress monitoring data has shown that it's not working well enough for a student. We do our diagnostic, and then we need to make adaptations to the program. So let's go ahead and think about what we're going to learn in this module. So part one, we're going to talk about how do you implement interventions with fidelity. In part two, we're going to focus on those adaptations. And then in part three, we're going to put it all together so that we see how DBI works with mathematics. So what are some of the activities that you're going to do? Well, you're going to look at different lessons and the fidelity checklists that go along with those lessons. You're going to create some of your own fidelity checklists. And then you're going to share your checklist and discuss how well your checklist gets to the important components of a video lesson. In part two, you're going to think about different ways to adapt math content and reflect on something that you've recently taught and include more explicit instruction there. And then you're going to do a discussion board where you describe different decisions that you've made about adaptations. And then finally, in part three, you're going to go and create a DBI implementation plan and then share that plan and hopefully your excitement for that plan with your colleagues. Now, you've seen this slide many, many, many times, but I will show it again. Remember, when we're thinking about good, high-quality instruction for students with learning difficulties, we want to rely on three things that deal with delivery of instruction. So explicit instruction, multiple representations, and concise language. And then we want to embed three strategies that are important to include within instruction. Those are fluency building, problem solving instruction, and a motivation component. For this module, we encourage you to read this article about intensive intervention in mathematics. It's a good article that talks about the whole process for how to get things started, so how to plan, how to implement, and then how to monitor intensive intervention. So we hope that you'll read that now, so it'll be a good reference as we go through this module. And so by the end of this module, after we talk about fidelity and adaptations and your plan for DBI, your application is to just go do it. It's time to get started. So welcome. Let's go ahead and get started on Module 8.